the National Front. The First Lady, Hillary Clinton, speaking on behalf of her husband and a Democratic fundraiser, quoted Eleanor Roosevelt to a packed audience of enthusiastic supporters.
Thank you.
Roosevelt made me think about one of her favorite sayings. She often said that a woman was like a tea bag.
Hello?
Relax.
I don't think she's going to be able to hold out much longer.
Would you stop it? It's perfectly normal in your condition to lose the interest in sex.
Maybe I should just force myself to satisfy. Maybe it's, you know, painful.
If it's really bothering you, why don't you just give him a blowjob? Carol?
I would if I could, honest, but just the thought of it right now.
Thought of what?
Nothing. Nothing.
Is that him?
He stopped humming. I liked it. You're a good hummer.
Carol, what is happening? We'll be right back.
finger.
Where the hell is my finger?
Why are you standing there?
Look for it!
Okay.
Jesus!
Okay.
Max, Carol!
You don't have to shout!
Yes, I do! I do have to shout, Carol! I definitely have to shout!
Okay.
Carol. What are you doing?
I'm looking for it!
What would it be doing in the fridge?
I don't know! I don't want... You're screaming at me! I can't see it!
I'm sorry, I don't know what came over me. Is this better, sweetie?
Thank you, that's very kind. But I don't allow Huey to chew on any scraps.
In our country today, we have allowed our families to drift apart, to break apart.
Come on, I'm driving you to the hospital. Mrs. Gilinski packed the nice. She used to be a nurse. She says you're going to be fine, not to worry. It can last for hours and they can put it back on, no problem. Happens all the time. But the sooner we get to the hospital, the better. Thank God her dog just saved. Thank God. But there's nothing to worry about. Mrs. Kalinski says you're going to be completely fine.
I've been...
Oh, God, I can't find my keys.
I've been thinking.
She was a nurse for 30
years. And I,
Did you know that?
I realized...
Did you know that? Don't worry, honey. We're going to get you right to the hospital. And you're going to be as good as new before you know it. You're going to be all right. You're going to be just fine. Mrs. Kalinski says you're probably in shock. Thank God I'm just saying. And that he doesn't like to chew. He just likes to hold things in his mouth. God, I can't put my keys. Did you see them?
Which is just...
Okay. She was a nurse for 36 years, Mrs. Kalinski. Did you know that? I didn't know that. Did you know that? Before she went blind, she said she saw all kinds of things. Once she said this guy walked in carrying his big toe. Can you imagine?
Big toe?
Yes. Are you okay? You'll be fine, honey. You'll be just fine. We're gonna get you right to the hospital, and before you know it, you're gonna be as good as new. You won't be as good as new, of course, not completely, because you might not feel it, even though it will be there.
Carol, but... did you hear what I said? Because I think it is something that we should talk about.
Can you get up?
Yes.
Mrs. says you're probably in shock. Oh, my God. Thank God he just did. Thank God. He doesn't like to chew. But just likes to hold things in his mouth. It's a good thing. It's a cute thing. Uh-huh. It's a You think he does? Because that's what she said. Thinking until just now.
What?
Before, in the house. You said I did it on purpose.
I did.
Why would I do it on purpose?
Chop off a finger. This is really this. Metaphorically speaking.
What are you talking about?
You know. Fun. I enjoyed that. I especially liked the part where you,
You think I castrated you to get back at you. Who is she?
It doesn't matter, Carol.
It matters.
She is not the problem. She is the symptom of a terrible marriage. Now, can we please go to the hospital, Carol? You want a divorce? Is that it? Because right now, I have no problem with that. But do you think we could discuss it after they put my finger back on?
No.
No.
Not until you tell me who she is.
Okay. Okay. It's all right. No, that's fine. That's fine. You know what? You stay here. I'm gonna walk, okay? It's only 4 blocks anyway. Carol.
I want her name.
You want the name.
That's right.
The name. You want a name. So, what you're saying is that you're not going to give me my finger back unless I give you a name.
Just tell me your name.
It's my finger, Carol! You're using my finger, as a bargaining chip! Ow! Ah! Ow! Give it to me! Give it to me! Give it to me! Ow! 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 How's the parking brake? Ow! 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 Oh, Jesus! Oh! Anymore, Carol.
You attacked me. I can't believe you attacked me.
You have my finger.
You were unfaithful.
I was not unfaithful, Carol. And even if I was, do you realize that we haven't had sex in 6 months? Count them, Carol. 6 months.
I'm pregnant.
So what? So you can't give me a blowjob?
My hormones are all screwed up.
Use that excuse for everything.
Tell me her name.
Quick, baby, get some water. The house is on fire.
I can't, sweetheart. My hormones are all screwed up.
My God, you know, what am I asking for, Carol? It's just a little mundane, run-of-the-mill, everyday oral sex. It's not like I'm asking you to drink poison.
A man has needs, Carol.
Urges, okay? And they don't just go away because you decide to ignore them.
Tell me her name!
A hand job! Or a hand job? I mean, what about a hand? There are all kinds of options, Carol! All kinds of options!
Tell me her name!
Pam!
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 Now hand it over!
Pam!
With my friggin' finger! Ow! Ow! Jesus!
Screwing my husband.
What?
Have you been screwing my husband?
I don't understand.
Oh! Well, what's going on?
She chopped off my finger, Pam.
My God! It was an accident! It was an accident. But Glenn thinks I did it on purpose now. Why would he think I did it on purpose, Pam?
Look, Carol, I don't know what's going on here, but I think you know!
Oh! Obviously, he thinks I was getting revenge. Revenge for what, Pam?
To work together. Think
what
about
happened?
The challenges.
I don't know what you're talking about. Don't lie to me. I swear. Oh, we discussed it once.
As far as it went, that's all. That's all.
Discussed? But we didn't do anything. Tell her, Glenn.
You discussed having sex with one another? No, we didn't use that word. Going to bed. We called it going to bed. Would you tell her, Glenn, for God's sakes?
You had a discussion.
I've been having some problems with Nick lately. He's been a little out of it. But things are better now. Sort of.
Who initiated it? I want to know.
Please.
I want to know who initiated. I think I have a right to know who made the first move. Nobody. Nobody moved, I swear. Please. Please.
Me. I asked her if she wanted to have sex with me.
Shut up. Shut up! That's not true. He didn't use that word.
I said Carol and I aren't sleeping together anymore. And I'm going out of my mind.
You see, Carol, you used the word sleeping.
I want to have sex with you. Will you have sex with me?
It was so long ago.
I said, I think about you, Pam, all the time. And she said, you do? Really? And I said, really? And she said, God, that makes me horny.
Could you?
What? How could I? What? I didn't do anything.
You were considering it. Isn't that enough?
No. No, Carol. That isn't enough. That isn't anything. We didn't act on it. And that's the most important part.
Mr. Mandel, the company's 52-year-old Austrian-born president, who was widely seen as the heir to AT&T's chairman and chief executive, Eric G. Nayland, said he was leaving to become the chairman of Associated Communications. No replacement was named for
him. It's kind of an act, thinking. And all the time, I thought he was thinking about me.
Look at him. He's in shock. He's probably lost a lot of blood. We gotta get him to the hospital.
Advancing issues outnumbered decliners by a 12-5 margin. NASDAQ Composite Index rose a healthy 10.5 points. The American Stock Exchange Composite Index rose modestly as biotechnology lagged behind.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Telecommunications industry.
I need to pee.
By a merger announcement today. More on that later. Bill Freeman with the Business Report. Doctors at Mount Sinai Hospital say they may have uncovered a rare cause of herpes. With the doctors say they are now isolating bacteria and may be able to come up with a cure in 2 years. The government has beefed up the research fund by two.
Yeah, this is a definite emergency. I'm holding a finger. No, it's a severed finger, someone lost a finger. I just need to know what to do with it, okay? Yeah.
Gwen, what are you doing here? Jesus, what's going on?
It's a long story.
Okay, so you'll come right away? Okay, thank you. All right.
Thank you.
I feel like a nice cold beer, honey. How about you, Glenn? You want a nice cold beer? I feel like a nice cold beer. Really cold, honey. The coldest one. Ice cold. Thank you.
Nick? What?
How about you, honey? You want a nice cold beer?
It's not even noon yet.
You hear that, Glenn? It's not even noon yet, she said. Did you hear that? Not even noon yet, she says. I love that. Isn't she something? I got you that beer anyway, pal. It's not nice and cold like I wanted. It's not even a little cold, actually. Actually, they're warm. Yeah. Pam forgot to put them in the fridge for me. Didn't you, honey? Actually, she didn't really forget. No, she didn't actually. Actually, she didn't put them in there on purpose. Ain't that right, sweetie? Oh, hi, Carol. I was just telling Glenn here how Pam didn't actually forget to put some beers in the refrigerator for me. Yeah, she actually put them in a spot where she thought I couldn't find them.
Nick.
You see, I'm an alcoholic. Yeah, did you know that, Glenn? Of course you knew that. Because everybody knows that. Especially the judge that revoked my license. He was a nice guy, though. Really nice guy. Ah, that was good. Warm, but good. Well, not that good, actually, but I needed the hit of alcohol.
Nick, in case you haven't noticed, there wasn't an accident.
No need. No need. Glenn filled me in on the entire situation while you were in the kitchen. Didn't you, Glenn? Hey, come on, guy, if you're not going to drink that beer, don't let it go to waste. That was terrible. But I'm an alcoholic, and I'll take my alcohol any way I can get it. Ain't that right, sweetums?
Nick, I don't know what Glenn told you, but I think that we should just...
Think. You think? And what do you think?
Please.
Not that it's all that important what you think. They're just thoughts, right? I mean, and what's in a thought? Nothing, right? A thought is just a thought, right?
That's right.
Wrong. In a way, I kind of admire you, Glenn. Me? I don't think much about anything. I'm a man of action. But a man of action who doesn't think is a fool. Isn't that right, Glenn? See, honey, he thinks I'm a fool.
But he didn't say anything.
No, but he was thinking it. He's good at thinking things, Glenn is. He's a very creative thinker, that Glenn. Not like me. I'm a chump. Isn't that right, Glenn? See?
Please, Nick.
Hey. You want to know something that happened to me today, everybody? My unemployment insurance is run out. Isn't that great? No more extensions. So from now on, it's official. I'm completely and totally dependent on Pam. Which is very demoralizing. But wait a minute. Now that is something I think about a lot.
Sweetheart,
what? What are you gonna say? Or better yet, what's on your mind? Huh? That I'm no longer a man? That I'm less than a man? That I have no dignity simply because my best friend and my wife were discussing having sex together?
Thank you.
Where's my gun, honey? I was looking for it just the other day and I couldn't find it. And you wouldn't happen to know where it is, would you? I spent hours looking for it the other day, hours. I looked everywhere and no gun. But hey, it wasn't like an entire waste of time, because that's how I found the beer. Yeah, imagine that. I'm looking for my gun and I won't tell you why. And lo and behold, beer. Yeah. Not a total waste of time, hell. I got so much time on my hands lately anyway.
I think it might be best if you and Glenn wait for the ambulance outside.
Did you lose something, sweetheart? I'd like my gun, Pam. Bring me my gun.
Please.
Give me my goddamn gun!
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. Hey, look at me. I'm doing some thinking.
Nick?
For once in my life, I'm finally doing some thinking. You know, like you were my best friend here.
Is that my finger?
Finished. Finished. I'm finished thinking. One time, perhaps, I might have forgiven.
You did sleep with someone, didn't you?
At the time, she said it was the only one. And that she wasn't thinking.
Nicky, wait!
You slept with someone else?
Uh-huh. Nick, wait, where are you going? What are you doing?
Wait a minute.
Nick,
please. No, no!
Nicky, where are you going?
Tell them, Pam.
Nick.
Sometimes thoughts do become deeds. You tell them.
Nick, please. Just slow down.
You talked. You said you weren't ready. What happened?
Nick. Twice I let it pass, Pam. Twice,
where
at least.
Where are you going?
Twice?
That's right.
What do you mean, twice? Twice?
Where are you going?
Where am I?
Why are we going to bank?
I thought we were talking.
Nick,
twice isn't exactly not ready.
I'm acting, Pam. Acting. I'm not just standing idly by anymore when you humiliate me by sleeping around. No, Pam, no. This time, I'm acting before you do.
You know, how long do we have to go over this, Nicky?
Alan Cohen. Of all the people, Pam, Alan Cohen.
Alan Cohen, your accountant. You slept with your accountant?
He is a tax consultant.
He's a fucking accountant, Pam. Oh, my God, I can't believe
Nicky.
It. He's my accountant, too. I sent you to him. For Christ's sakes, what kind of warped logic is that? I mean, if you're gonna think about it, if you're gonna sleep with somebody outside of your marriage, who would you choose? Your accountant, who you barely know, or your best friend's husband? I mean, come on. Oh, what are you looking at?
Shut up.
No, I will not shut up. Besides the point, he's a lousy accountant. He makes mistakes. You know how much I have to pay him penalties?
Nick, what are you doing?
I'm making a deposit.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
You're not. Yes, he is. Nick.
It's no use, Pam. I've set my mind to it.
It's gonna get squished by the machine. Is that what you want, Nicky?
Nick, I...
To squish it?
Maybe...
You think
maybe you want to think about that, Nick.
Long and hard, Nicky. Long and hard, because once you squish it, there's no turning back.
I know that. You don't think I know that?
Excuse me.
Who are you?
I'm Mr. Cozzell, the bank manager. Is there some problem?
Problem? No. No problem. Just making a deposit. Can I make a deposit?
That is not your deposit to make.
Actually, it's mine.
No, it isn't. It's mine. Well, it was his, but we're getting a divorce, so now half of it is mine, technically.
Oh, Jesus.
All right, everybody, faces on the floor, faces on the floor. Now.
Can I sit?
Sure. But don't try anything stupid. Good. You slug fucks! You bunch of slug fucks! I'll splatter your fucking heads across the fucking carpeting! You slug fucking motherfuckers! How would you like that, man? How would you like me to splatter your fucking heads across the fucking carpeting? Would anybody like me to do that? Would anybody like me to splatter their fucking heads across the fucking carpeting? Now empty your fucking pockets, you motherfuckers! Go, go, go!
Excuse me. I'm sorry. But could you not take that envelope?
What the fuck are you doing, asshole? Huh? Huh? You want to get your fat fucking head blown off your fucking shoulders? Is that what you want, motherfucker? For me to blow your motherfucking brains out of your motherfucking skull?
Oh!
Huh? Oh. Huh? You want to take my gun and put it to your big fat head? Pull the fucking trigger and give you the fastest freaking haircut on the face of the fucking planet? Is that what you want me to do, motherfucker?
It's just about what is in that envelope is of no value to you.
Is that right? You think we have the fucking time to discuss that with you, dickhead? Do you think it's worth our goddamn time to have a goddamn discussion about that with you? Do you believe this fucking asshole here, man? I mean, do you believe this stupid asshole? This is a fucking bank robbery. We are fucking bank robbers with fucking firearms. Loaded fucking firearms! Do you have any idea how freaking dangerous that is? What are you, some kind of stupid idiot? What kind of fucking stupid idiot are you anyway?
Very stupid idiot. Sorry.
I let you sit, man. You asked me if you could sit, and I let you sit.
You want to know something? She cut it off on purpose.
Don't listen to him. He's in shock.
Three people are talking. Three people are opening their fucking mouths during a fucking bank robbery. Do you fucking people have any fucking idea how fucking dangerous that fucking is?
Shoot me. I want you to shoot me. Oh. She took my gun away or I would have done it myself last week. But she took my gun away so I couldn't do it. Please, shoot me dead.
Four? Now it's four.
This is Captain Barillo of the Rutherton Police. Put down your weapons. Come out with your hands in the air, and no one will be hurt.
Oh, Christ, Lenny. You said this was gonna be easy.
How the fuck was I supposed to know that we'd be robbing a bunch of motherfucking blabbermouths? If everybody shut the fuck up like they were supposed to, we would have been the fuck out of here already.
Can I have the envelope, please?
Shoot me!
I repeat, put down your weapons, come out with your hands in the air, and no one will be hurt.
What are we gonna do now?
What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? We're gonna take a fucking hostage! That's what the fuck we're gonna fucking do!
Please, take me. Take me!
Nick!
No offense, pal, but I was thinking maybe we should take somebody slightly less out of their fucking mind!
Please. I need the finger.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, asshole! And frankly, I don't give a flying fuck! You!
But she's pregnant!
Exactly! And so least likely to give us any fucking trouble!
Move it, move it, move it! Everyone stay on the floor! Move it!
All right, hold the line!
Everybody get back! Don't try any stupid shit, you tacky bastards! Or I'll blow all your heads off! I'm crazy, I'll do it! I'll blow all your heads off for your fucking necks! Stay back! Stay back!
You all right?
Fucking piece of fucking shit!
We're not bad people, it's just that Lenny's a little loud.
What the hell just happened?
I did it. I cut it off on purpose.
What the fuck is going on?
His finger.
His what?
It's not on his hand.
I think it's bleeding again.
He's bleeding. To death, I hope. I hope he bleeds to death. What if he does?
mean, you said yourself, Letty, as long as nobody gets killed and we can call him beyond the year on good behavior, that's what you
said. Calm the fuck down!
Wait, Letty, if he dies, we can get blamed for it.
All right, calm down, will you?
Oh, Jesus.
Shut up! Shut up!
This is murder! First degree murder!
Look, he's not fucking dead yet, all right? We're right near a hospital. We'll drop him off.
Here, you give it to him.
Do I have to?
Yes, 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 you have to, you have to.
Here.
No.
No.
No, what do you mean no?
No.
Oh, shit.
Easy.
You were letting him go. He should have been fucking grateful.
I'm not taking it. Unless she gives it to me willingly.
He's gonna die. He's gonna die. We're gonna get the electric chair.
Give her the fucking finger, Selena.
I don't want it.
Put it in her fucking hand.
You're gonna take this finger because I don't want it. Look, just
give it. That's it. Give me the finger. Take the fucking wheel.
Unbelievable. I don't believe this. You're gonna take this. Take it.
Take it. Take it. There, now give him his goddamn motherfucking finger.
You want it? Go get it.
Goddamn relationship, for Christ's sakes.
Really? I mean, we've been married for almost 5 years now.
5 beautiful fucking years, man. Count them. Count them, motherfuckers.
Really? Really?
You tell him, babe. You tell him. Fucking A. Fucking A. Fucking A. Right, correct.
And has he ever cheated on you?
Oh, no. Mm-mm.
Never, man. Never. Never.
Never.
Till death do us fucking part, man. You know what I'm saying? Till the end and fucking beyond.
He never even think about it.
right?
I mean, that's not the point.
All right, now take it easy. Keep back. We're obviously dealing with some very disturbed individuals.
Who? Just give me one example. One lousy example.
Fucking irrelevant. It's just a fucking thought. Lots of people have fucking thoughts.
It's Mimi Rodriguez, isn't it? That bitch, Mimi Rodriguez. You think that's her real hair color? That is not her real hair color.
Leave Mimi the fuck out of this. What the fuck did Mimi ever do to you, huh?
I'm scared, Cap.
It's totally normal.
I knew it. I knew it. What did I tell you? What did I tell you?
I like red highlights. What fucking guy on the face of the fucking planet doesn't like red fucking highlights?
I cannot believe this. You are unbelievable. Unbelievable. I can't believe this. What the
fuck? Oh, here we go.
Out! I don't think I can live with you anymore, then.
I hate you! And your finger!
Thank you.
Here.
A quiet suburban town was rocked to its core today. Chad Williamson reports live from the scene. Go ahead, Chad.
Corey, what authorities described as a bank holdup gone bad soon escalated into a high-speed car chase, kidnapping, attempted murder, and even a grisly maiming. Before it ended, finally all behind me here at approximately 7:50 p.m. this evening. It all began at the Garden Federal Savings Bank on Broadway in the normally quiet middle-class suburb of Rutherton, New Jersey. Two gunmen wearing nylon stockings over their heads entered the bank at approximately 12:45 p.m. this afternoon and announced a holdup. However, before the gunmen could flee, the street outside was swarming with local law enforcement. It was at this point that the trapped gunmen took two hostages, a man and a woman still unidentified as human shields, and attempted to escape. What followed was a long, tense, often treacherous car chase, which took literally and figuratively many turns. Some of the very gruesome details are still coming to light.
Is it true that one of the gunmen cut off one of their hostages' fingers?
That's correct. Apparently, one of the perpetrators severed the little finger from the right hand of the male hostage. They then tossed it out of the back of the getaway vehicle. Now, we're only assuming at this point that they did this as a threat to prove to us that they mean business.
How many know where the finger is?
I don't know. After temporarily eluding their police pursuers and leaving their hostages for dead on a muddy roadside, the suspects were finally cornered approximately 1/2 mile east of Farmerville on a deserted stretch of Old Pasquatch Highway. It was at this point that police moved in and found one of the suspects, identified tonight as one Leonard Theodore McCauley, dead of a gunshot wound to the back of the head. Corey, police sources are telling us here off the record that the fatal wound seems to have been inflicted by McCauley's companion, one Selena Grossman, who is now identified as his common law wife. She's in custody after reportedly surrendering to authorities without resistance and is being questioned as we speak. Details are obviously evolving rapidly in this case, and we'll be bringing you updates as they develop. This is Chad Williamson live in Rutherton, New Jersey. Back to you, Corey.
Thank you, Chad. Terrible. On the national front, the First Lady, Hillary Clinton, speaking on behalf of her husband and a Democratic fundraiser, quoted Eleanor Roosevelt to a packed audience of enthusiastic supporters.
You know, your mention of Mrs. Roosevelt made me think about one of her favorite sayings, and she often said that a woman was like a tea bag.
They shot my hand up with an anesthetic. It was completely numb. We're in Mercy Hospital. You passed out. I is, I had a nice talk with my surgeon and his associates. They're gonna come back in a few minutes and put it back on. I am shot so full of Demerol. You ever have the sensation you could turn your head a full 360 degrees?
Anne wasn't the only one, was she?
Huh?
She wasn't the only one.
You mean the only one I... Well, no. There were a lot.
Such as?
There was the checkout girl at the shop, Mark. I used to, all the time. The mailman, Rita. Her name was Rita. I guess that makes her a male woman. It just doesn't sound right. Male woman. She's, gone on to another route, so. I miss her. Rita. Every time I heard the mailbox clink, I would imagine her in those shorts with the little black socks. Anyway, she's gone on to another route. I used to fantasize about that checkout girl all the time. Zoe. Her name was Zoe. I know because she had a little name tag. It said, "Hi, my name is Zoe." A little smiley face on him, so cute.
Used to.
Hmm?
You said used to. You used to with Rita?
Yeah.
And you used to with,
Zoe.
Sorry. But then you stopped.
Yeah.
Used to, that's the past tense. I mean, so they were both in the past tense. That means they're over.
Yeah, over.
There's another one, isn't there? And this one is in the present tense, isn't she? Isn't she? I bet you she's smart. Pretty? Very pretty.
Beautiful. Sexy. Warm. Tender, thoughtful, understanding, silly, loving. You want to know who she is, Carol? Would you like to know who she is?
No. No, I don't care.
Yes, you do.
No, no, I don't. I don't care.
You're dying to.
No, I don't.
Yes, you are.
I don't care.
You're dying.
Drop dead, you freak! You freak! A sick, sorry, pathetic little freak! You want a blowjob? I'll give you a blowjob! Here! Here!
Her. Not her.
And that's her. Stay tuned for the business report with Bill Freeman. This is Corey Chang for the All News Network.
In your dreams.
Yeah. That's it, Carol. In my dreams. In my fantasies. But they were real nonetheless, Carol. Pure and complete and vivid and real. In some ways, more real than anything you and I ever had. Think about that, Carol. Think about that hard. What do you want to know, Carol? Know where I touched her?
You're crazy.
You want to know what she sounded like? How she moaned? How she sighed? How she trembled in ecstasy? Oh, Glenn. Do it to me. Oh, baby. Oh, Glenn.
So let's get to it.
Wasn't there a thing of...
Is enough, Carol. It's mine. I'll give it back.
You made me feel small!
I made you feel small after you wouldn't give me my finger back.
You wouldn't tell me who you were having sex with!
Because, Carol, I wasn't having sex. I was thinking about having sex!
Oh, right! With my best friend!
Okay, Carol. Seriously, no. Give me the finger back, sweetie.
Not until I have satisfaction. Hey! I told you where to go, so go!
Don't listen to her. She's a thief. A thief and an extortionist.
And he's a lying, deceitful, adulterous, duplicitous piece of shit.
That's right. This is all coming from the woman who just gave my dismembered finger a blowjob.
And you still went up to me. You still went up me! You had satisfaction, now I want satisfaction!
Satisfaction. Are you listening to this? Satisfaction. Oh, that's very funny, Carol. Satisfaction. Does this look like I had satisfaction to you?
Great! Great! You scared him off!
Small, Carol. Is that it? I made you feel small? Well, you don't know the half of it. You don't know the hundredth, the gazillionth of how small you're gonna feel if you don't give me back my goddamn finger right now. Right now, Carol. If you don't give me back my finger in 10 seconds, I am going to give you
every single sexual uncensored detail. Do you understand? Do you understand, Carol? 10, 9, 8. I'm counting, Carol. 7, 6, 5, 4.
Began making tiny, tiny, teeny, weeny, infinitesimal circular motions. First clockwise, then counterclockwise, and clockwise again. Circular motions getting larger and larger, growing and growing in circumference, widening and widening as she made her way through the wispy curls of my treasure trail.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Corey Chang.
You have an appointment?
No.
Your name, please. Your name, please.
You may say that the wife of the man whose brains she has been fucking out is here to see her.
No, lady.
No, no, you look. Look at me. Look at me, I'm pregnant, I'm pregnant. She took my husband. She took my husband. She let him do with her what he wanted. All kinds of dirty, filthy, sexual things. And she made circles with her tongue. She made little circles with her tongue. Infinitesimal circles with her tongue. And,
night, Tony. Jay. Oh, Jesus, Scott, you scared the shit out of me.
How? How could you?
How could I what?
All those late nights you said you were working. All those excuses. I trusted you, Corey. I believed you. Look at her. Look at her, Corey! That's his wife, Corey. His wife. She came here to confront you, to face you. And I think, considering her condition, she deserves at least that much. As for me,
thank you.
Who told you? Well, how did you find out? I had no idea you were... Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't know how much you know. We met when I was on assignment in Washington. It just happened. He never mentioned that you were, but you should know, it was me. I mean, he loves you. He said he would never leave you. I wanted him to leave you. I begged him. Oh, I tried every trick in the book. But he said he could never, that you were his rock at Gibraltar. But he was nothing without you. Oh, the way he talked about you, it made me jealous. It made me just... Anyway, I just think you ought to know that you're a very lucky woman. I'll never see him again. I swear, okay? Just tell him. Tell him. Tell him I said goodbye.
Bitch.